Nets fans have been waiting the better part of 2 years for Kevin Durant's postseason debut in black and white, and he delivered with 32 points as the Nets beat the Boston Celtics 104-93 to take a 1-0 lead in that 2-7 series. Welcome in, everybody. It is Playoff Central Live presented by State Farm. Steve Smith right there. I'm Matt Weiner. Good to have you with us. Sam Mitchell is in the room as well, but not over here at our table, which is disappointing for us.
Am I supposed to say something?
No, you can say whatever you like.
I can see you guys and
I know
you
we can
guys
see you.
Just kinda, yeah, I feel like I'm at home almost, but they could have let me stay at home if they're going to put me over here. That's all.
It's nothing personal.
It feels that way, though.
We're short on plexiglass, so we have you over there. Sam, I'm going to go to you first so you feel like you're involved. Is this what folks expected from the Brooklyn Nets? I mean, it was kind of a rough start for them. They were one of, what, 16, I think, in the first half from three-point range. Kevin Durant said afterward it took a little while. There was some nerves to work out, but ultimately their big three and their offense was too much for Boston to overcome.
Yeah, man. I mean, look, if you look at the stats tonight, I can't see Brooklyn playing any worse. This was a perfect opportunity for the Boston Celtics coming to Brooklyn and win this game. Look, they was awful from the three-point line, from the two-point line. The only two things they did well tonight was make free throws and rebound. And third, they played defense. So for all the people that think this Brooklyn team can't play defense, it blows my mind. They have three future Hall of Fame players. And Steve Smith will tell you this. When veteran players decide to make up their mind to play defense, it's the same defense they've been playing since kids. Help and recover, see man and see ball. Nothing has changed. So for people to think Kevin Durant, Kyrie Irving, and James Harden, and those other veterans that they put on this team can't play defense, I think tonight they proved them different.
Yeah, and I'm with you, Sam. I look at it as, like you said, I'm looking down as the big three, they shot 5 for 24. Matt and Sam from the three-point line, but they did. This is where it counts. They got to the free throw line, those three, 27 times, and they made 25. They didn't shoot the ball great, and as you can see in that first half, we started to worry. We were looking and saying, hey, let's look at the second half. The second half, Sam said it best, Matt. The Boston Celtics only scored 40 points in the second half. So if you can start to lock in defensively, there's nothing wrong with winning ugly playoff games. It's a win. And I think for the Brooklyn Nets to get that win, keep getting these games, I think, Sam, Matt, it's almost better for them to have this close game versus they came out and got 175 and everybody had 30, 40 triple doubles. I think they had to grind one out a little bit. And I think this is going to bode well for the Brooklyn Nets down the road.
I mentioned Brooklyn. I actually think I misspoke. It was 1 of 13 from three in the first half. Boston was 2 of 13 in the second half. Celtics are at times a clunky offensive team to begin with. Really, they need Jason Tatum to have huge nights to have chances in this series. What can they be if he's not going for 35 or 40?
You know, Matt, I think it's going to be hard on Brad Stevens. Also, Jason Tatum. Do you come out and be a decoy? He still got the hunt shot. Give it up. I thought Marcus Smart helped him play well. I thought Jabari Parker off the bench, he might need to get a little bit more minutes. He was 3 of 6. He played well, but they just don't have enough firepower offensively right now without Jaylen Brown. They struggle. You can see not only missing shots, just to be able to get into their counters, just to get to their movement. They need somebody in the offseason, not right now.
Yeah.
Hopefully, you know, they can get a chance to get somebody that can make some plays for them off the bounce. Kemba Walker is the likely suspect right now, but he has struggled. I think the size of what they put on him right now, him finishing at the rim, I think everybody now, as you saw in the bubble and the playoffs, they're planning close and making him drive the basketball and trying to finish over the top.
Yeah, Sam, Kemba Walker was supposed to be that guy, right? Or one of those guys. He was 5 of 16 tonight. Is there anything he can do or Brad Stevens can do to free him up and make him more productive?
Is Jaylen Brown coming back anytime soon?
No.
I don't think so. Look, man, this is their team right now. And for this Boston Celtics team, man, they just don't have the firepower. They don't have the guys coming off the bench. And this is something Danny Ainge and Brad Stevens are going to have to sit down and talk about because they got to improve this roster. Look, Jason Tatum is going to give them everything he has, but he's going to have to force some tough shots, take bad shots. He's got to get the ball up at the rim to give them a chance. Brooklyn knows that. They're going to load up and make other guys scores. They're going to make Kemba Walker play defense. They're going to put him in pick and rolls. They're going to attack him. And that's the best way when you're playing against two guys like Kemba Walker and Jason Tatum, and they are under man, the best thing you could do to hurt their offense is to attack them on defense. And who's better than James Harden, Kyrie Irving, and Kevin Durant?
Tatum had just 22 on 20 shots. Mm-hmm. Marcus Smart was the Boston's Celtics' second-leading scorer with 17. First postseason coaching victory for Steve Dash tonight, and here he is after the Nets take a 1-0 lead.
Great. We will get started with Michael Brady from Yes Network.
So it's first opportunity to create a shared experience when it comes to the postseason. What was the big takeaway and what you guys were able to accomplish in game one?
Yeah, we found a way to win. You know, we didn't play well offensively. Some of it was shot making. Some of it was cohesion. Some of it was just, I think, first time out in the playoffs with fans. The atmosphere was unbelievable. Our fans were incredible. We knew it would be fun to play in front of the fans, but to step out there and see the place, you know, packed like that, and the energy in the building was unbelievable. So I think there was a little bit of newness in many ways. We weren't sharp offensively, but we found a way. We were tough, physical, defensively. You know, we made our share of mistakes, but we covered it up with an intensity and a will, and, you know, held them to 40 points in the second half.
And expounding on that, you know, how big was that, what you guys were able to shake off in the first half, buckle down, and take advantage of in the second half and pull away?
Yeah. I mean, the first half was just so uncharacteristic from a shot-making standpoint for us. You know, that put us in a bit of a hole, but, you know, I think we all had confidence that it'd be hard to shoot that poorly in the second half. Still plenty of things to clean up, plenty of things to look at and to develop and to continue to get better at. You know, not a great performance at all at that end of the floor, but plenty to be proud of defensively and plenty to build on down there.
Alex Schiffer with The Athletic.
Hey, Steve, I got two for you. There's something that starting five you've been talked a lot about is what you think was one of your best, but obviously hadn't played before. Do you attribute any of the slow start you guys had to the lack of familiarity with that starting five?
I'm sure it's some of it, you know. I'm sure it's some of it, but I think it was just more the occasion. You know, it was just a... You know, everyone was excited, and, you know, the place was packed, and maybe we just rushed. We were just a little impatient to start the game. So I'd probably say the truth is somewhere in the middle, a little bit of that they haven't played much together, a little bit that, you know, it was an exciting evening for everyone to walk in the gym and see that many people, and our fans were outstanding. And I just think, you know, it was all new, or off to a fresh start, and, you know, we just weren't really sharp offensively, so... Probably a few factors contributed.
Ryan Lewis with the New York Post.
Hey, Steve, how much did Robert Williams, I mean, his rim protection, I mean, how much did that contribute to your guys' struggles, or were you playing into his hands?
I would say both. You know, I think too many times we kind of lined him up to go against him, you know, when we didn't unnecessarily. But he was outstanding. And then, you know, other times, you know, he was just great. You know, he made big plays, whether it was on the ball, off the ball, and used his length and athleticism. But I think there was times where we were you know, a little bit naive at times to go at him unnecessarily in the wrong positions.
Christian Winfield with the New York Daily News.
Hey, Coach. You know, you talked that you guys didn't play too well, especially earlier on, but even though you guys didn't play well, you guys were never too far away from being able to close the gap. I'm wondering if that ability to make up that distance, even though you didn't play well early, is that something that you guys can consider as a confidence booster going forward? I mean, obviously you guys don't want to play poorly to start these games, but the fact that you didn't play your best and you were only within arm's distance basically the whole game, does that do anything for you guys?
Yeah, I think so. You know, I think it was our defense was pretty solid. You know, they had 32 in the second quarter, but 21, 20, 20 in the other three quarters. So I think we recognized we could stay close by defending. You know, I thought we had a good start. I think it was like a 13-4 run to start the second half, which was important. But I don't know that our confidence wavered tonight. We just weren't as sharp as we normally are. And just proud of the guys for the way they battled defensively.
Ian O'Connor with the New York Post.
Yeah, Steve, this was obviously the first time Kevin's played in a postseason game since a pretty devastating injury a couple of years ago. I was just curious what your emotions or sentiment was for him, given the kind of performance he had in his first postseason game since that moment.
Well, it's exciting to see him out there. I mean, the whole ride this year, seeing him come back from such a devastating injury, have such a long layoff, such a, you know, a big hill to climb, and a lot of doubt. I mean, who knows, you know, if he comes back to anywhere near the level he's accustomed to. So a tribute to his work ethic, his sacrifice, his talent, that he's still able to play at an incredibly high level after that injury and that layoff. And, you know, he didn't have a classic for him tonight, but you look up, he still had 32 and 12 and, you know, got to the line and did all the things you need to do to win. So proud of him, happy for him, and I know our fans were excited to see him out there tonight in the playoffs again.
Back to Alex Schiffer.
About Boston's ability to clean up on the offensive glass being a priority. Just curious to think how you guys did there tonight.
Yeah, how did it end up? They had 11 offensive rebounds. You know, you'd like to keep it lower than that, but then you look over at ours, and we had some as well. So overall, it wasn't the discrepancy that we were worried about. The shots were even, and, you know, that's positive. But this is not something that ever goes away for our team. You know, we've got to rebound, and we've got to rebound as a group and collectively go in there and help each other out and try to take away some of these offensive glass opportunities for the other team.
Last question, Greg Logan with Newsday.
Steve, can you just, I'm sorry if you've been asked this, but can you just comment on the physicality of your team's defense in the second half, holding them to 40 points?
Yeah, you know, the guys were great. You know, we didn't have a great outing offensively, but our defense was great. You know, they were locked in, they were physical, and worked together. So, you know, plenty to build on there. Hopefully we can improve a little bit at that end as well. But obviously our defense was better than our offense tonight.
Thanks, Coach. We appreciate it.
Brooklyn's Big Three.